Hi guys, and thank you for being interested in this tutorial, which I will talk about the auto layout updates that were made in the config 2023 wrap, minimum width and maximum width. Let's see what we can do with that. So I have a mobile screen here, which I want to do a screen which is quite similar to this one, which is choose your interest from TikTok. Okay, I took the screenshot from mobin.com, so you can go ahead if you want to explore there. They have a lot of leading applications, like all the screen of the application that you can take from there. Basically, it's not that they are promoting or I have anything to do with them for this tutorial. I just took it from there, so I thought it would be nice to give them the credit. Okay, anyway, that's why I'm mentioning them. So basically, the wrap is like when you take a text paragraph, for example. Okay, and do something like that, and I just kind of like write letter. I'm writing words. So what it does here is, because I already set the width of this text area, so when I'm continuing to write, it breaks the text actually to the second line, the third line, and so on. So basically, in auto layout, wonderfully and very much expected already, now it is doing pretty much the same. So I will take this chip, I will just drag one into the screen, and I will duplicate another one and put it near it, do them both in an auto layout. Let's call it chips, and I will just I don't know, I will change this icon. Let's put a smile and let's call happy trips. I'm just throwing stupid things into the screen, but just to kind of like demonstrate whatever it does. Yeah, just of course that these icons, they don't really mean anything. It's just something that I did just for the sake of this tutorial to show the behavior of these chips. So by the way, that's something which catches me in my everyday work, and it's very helpful. And I will set the width of this tutorial to be up to here, and I will give it a wrap behavior. So before, if you wanted actually to make two lines of chips, 2, 3, 4, 5, I don't know, 10 lines of chips, then you couldn't wrap them as I did with the text area before. You just had to duplicate like that, hook them up in another auto layout, and then duplicate it and make it like, you know, you would have like 2 or 3 chips in a row, and basically that's how it would behave. And now what it does is that behaves automatically. Notice the fact that when I control D, I control or command, if you're working on Mac. I'm a PC lover, sorry for all you Mac guys out there, but anyway, of course, joking, each one in whatever he loves to do. And control D, so you see that it already breaks it to the second line, which is pretty great. So then we can, let's change the icon here and do something. Why do I go to the lab? Blush. Okay, let's call blushing. I'm making myself laugh. Blushing trips. Blushing trips. Let's say blushing wonderful trips. Yeah, and then I'm going to duplicate another one, and it's going to throw it below because it's too long. But if you will see now that I will make it, let's say fire, and let's just write fire. You see, so not for fur, fire. Yeah, so you see, when it's short, it kind of like it arranges them in the way that we need them to be arranged already on the screen, which is pretty great. Okay, so let's kind of like, yeah, I'm gonna duplicate more, and I'm gonna put it here. And yeah, by the way, you can go here. Why did you jump down here? And I will duplicate another one and another one. And let's have kind of like, let's duplicate another one and throw it here. And let's take a short one and throw it here. And let's do something like that. Okay, so basically now, so we have them all kind of like lined up the way that they should be. You can also do deselected and show how it's selected and so on. And now actually, I didn't actually do these ones. These are in auto. Okay, so I will do this one in left and right. Left and right to the frame, to the main frame, the screen frame that actually holds it. So you will see that now when I'm expanding this frame, Okay, look what happens now. You see, it already kind of like sets whatever, the area, the chips area is actually behaving very responsively as the text area would behave as well. Of course, I didn't set these. This one needs to be constrained to the left side and so on, but basically, yeah. So, I mean, I didn't set these ones as well, but just to show you that area. So basically that is pretty wonderful. Okay, great. So that works really nice. By the way, I need to set this one to the left, and this one has to be actually left and right, and this one needs to be left and right. And now you will see that when I am expanding this frame, so it all kind of like behaves like it should. Okay, great. So one second. Okay, yeah, I was thirsty, I need to drink something. So anyway, so that's the first kind of like something that you could work with in the everyday base, and that's pretty nice and pretty cool. So that behaves wonderful, actually. And now I will show also the wrap and the minimum and maximum width. So we have here a product cube. Let me see that I didn't forget anything. Yeah, no, I did. I hope so. Okay, so I'm just dragging one to the screen. Let's say a product cube, a place cube, whatever cube, doesn't matter. It's kind of a content card, and that's gonna serve our cause of demonstrating whatever we want to demonstrate. Okay, so let's put it here. I'll put it something like that, and I'm gonna duplicate another one, hook them up in an auto layout. Let's call them cubes. Yeah, of course, these names they don't make too much sense, but anyway, doesn't matter. And of course, I will set the width of it, and now I will start duplicating one more and one more. And when I give it the wrap behavior, okay, like that. So now when I will duplicate another one, you will see that it breaks it to the second line and so on. So that is pretty cool, already doing the work for us. Very nice. Now, let's say that we have this situation, and in this situation, I want to give them, first of all, I want to give them an auto spacing. Okay, now the auto spacing, by the way, which is another change that Figma did to the auto layout, the auto spacing was here, if you remember it. I mean, we had here spacing mode. Yeah, it took me a while to remember it, but yeah, the spacing mode. Anyway, so in the spacing mode, we could have put it on packed or space between, which is automatic auto spacing, automatically spacing the item inside the auto layout. So now it is here. You have the space, a horizontal gap between items. They call it a bit different. It used to be space between elements. And here now you can actually select auto. So it's going to distribute them evenly inside the width of this auto layout. Okay, so that is happening here. By the way, you can always just write auto and it will do the work. And we can select all these and give them a fill container, so it's going to align them or to set them actually according to this width, the maximum that they can fit. And we can give them actually more spacing between them, and let's go by something, not this one, yeah, sorry, this one. Now it's on auto, and I will give them actually not 29, I'm gonna give them something like 10. Okay, great. So we have it set like that. So look how easily we kind of like distribute them on the width of this auto layout. Here, by the way, the same thing. If I will give it a wrap behavior and I will duplicate one more, so as you see, oh no, now it is kind of like squeezing them because they are in a fill container. So I need to give them a fixed with. And as you see now, again, if I will duplicate, they will just go something like that. Okay, so now how can we set it maybe to behave a bit more smart, or kind of like, you know, more to the way that we want it sometimes, to kind of like be a bit narrower or a bit wider and behave more dynamically. So we can do it with actually setting this one. We can set them to a fill container, but we're going to add something now. We are going to add now a minimum width of, now you see that these ones are, the cubes are in the width of 346. Let's give them a minimum width of, let's say, 300. Let me see. No, let's give them even less. Let's give them like 280. Okay, that's good. So this one is going to be the minimum width of this card. Okay, so they, if I will squeeze this area, it will go up to 280. We can give them, you know what, let's give them even 260. So it will go down to 260, and then it will start bringing them to the second line, and the other cards will behave also in a responsive way to the width. Let's see how it happens. So now I'm gonna start squeezing this one, and you see that when I reach the minimum width of them, so you see that now, you see what happened? This card, I know it looks pretty weird. I mean, honestly, in real designs, we're not gonna do something like that because that looks a bit weird. But anyway, yeah, I'm gonna keep on doing that, and you will see this card jumping to that line as well as we reach the minimum width of these cards. So I'm squeezing them, and up, now we have them four here. So you see how basically beautiful it behaves. And if we will keep on squeezing them, by the way, they will be lined up. Let me take the screen and give it a bit more height. Yeah, so they will get lined up one below each other. Now you will see, you see, now we got that. So this is how they behave. Again, of course, that in real designs, it's not always exactly how we want them to behave, meaning like that. Okay, but basically you can change designs very easily with this wrapping behavior, which is pretty awesome. By the way, we can also do the same. If we do here, I will set the maximum width. Okay, I can set also the maximum width. Now they are 352. Let's give them a maximum width of, let's say, 400. Let me see how that works. Okay, so now I will go like that, and this is their maximum width. So you see, when it reaches the maximum width, it gets them to the upper line or the line below. So we are playing with the minimum and the maximum width of them, and the area actually behaves according to that. Okay, so yeah, here we will keep on, even if I will keep on doing it, one second, I'm going to show you to it more clearly. So I'm going to actually do something like that. Yeah, it looks pretty weird, I know, but anyway, if I will make this area wider, you see it will do that up to the point that they reach the 400 of width. Okay, so now actually we can do the auto layout in centered. Okay, and when I will go and do like that, so you will see that now they keep on kind of like they just stay in the center, but they do not become wider than 400, which can look sometimes it can start looking pretty weird, and we don't want our content cards to behave too weirdy. Let's define it like that. Yeah, so that's what I mean. So minimum and what maximum, maximum. Yeah, that's pretty interesting. Maximum. Yeah, so not maximum, I'm saying maximum. Yeah, maximum can be weird and maximum altogether, so that could be maximum. Yeah, that's yeah, I'm inventing a new word here, so that's also nice. Yes, and so that is the minimum and maximum width of these cards, and you see the way that all the behaviors that we can actually achieve with that. So that is pretty cool. And yeah, I guess that that kinds of wraps up all the updates that we have on the auto layout. I hope I didn't miss anything. I don't think so. We talked about the wrap minimum, maximum. We saw where is the auto spacing now. By the way, you can do the same by just writing here auto. And when you write auto, it's gonna do the same. Okay, just for you guys to know. What else? Yeah, I guess that that's pretty much it. Really great behavior, miracles. Honestly, much easier to work with the auto layout now. Go ahead, try it, see how it works for your designs, and I would be very happy for your like, and would be more happy if you subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in the next tutorial. So thank you, and see you in the next one.